did that. I started with this is a zero. And I continue until I saw the one. Okay, let's continue. We got the right one is zero and the left one is one. Not change anything. After I saw one, and I will change the other one. Let's see the other one in my rules also. I will start the write and write it the exactly the numbers 0 0 0. I don't see the any one and I because so I don't want to change any numbers. So I see the one, the last one. So it means no change. If you can do these rules, so it means you if you invert the these numbers and add the one, you get the same results. So let's see that. I am started with write. I see the one in the first one, so I write it and I invert the all of them. Just flip them. Okay, this is a negative numbers rules. One rules. First rules is the use the sign bit in the MSB, most significant bit. If you use zero, it means positive. If you use one, it means negative. The other rules is the first complement. But for this, you have to say that. You have to say somehow I am using the complement numbers. And that means the transfer protocol. So the second complement. Can you see the point of this? I think I am using but. Can you see now? For example, this. But it was working last week, but now it didn't. What about now? Can you see that? Okay, good. Let's see these rules again. These rules, the second complement, you take the binary numbers, you flip it, all of bits. It means you invert the binary numbers. So zero invert to one, one invert to zero, and invert to all of the each bits, and add one. Just addition. But I have another rules, as I said. I start with the right and continue until I saw the one. For example, I started right. There's a zero. Okay, write the zero. And there is a one. Okay, write the one. But after one, I invert all of numbers. This is my rule. It works. Trust me. For example, this one, I started right and I continue until I see the one, and one is the last one, so it is the same. First complement is the same in number. So let's see this one. This one, I see the one in the right, so I flip the others. I invert the other numbers. It is the second complement rules. So there's a signed binary numbers example. But as I said, there is a 4 bits binary numbers you have. If you use signed bit, you only can use the 3 bits for the transfer data or using the data. The MSB bits is the sign one, sign bit. So actually it is not the desired situation. We don't desire that one because we want to use all of bits for calculation, for transfer data, for everything. So Let's see binary codes. It means binary coded decimal BCD. You will hurt it a lot if you have the laboratories and if you will work the FPGA. You will hurt a lot the BCD coding, and there's a symbol. For example, 0 means 0, 0, 0. 1 means 0, 0, 1. You have to memorize this table. You have to know that. Actually, it is just a binary decimal conversion, right? For example, let's see the 9. 1 plus 2 power of 0, it means 1. And 2 power of 1, 2 power of 2, 2 power of 3. It means 8. 1 plus 8 is 9. It's just binary to decimal conversion. But in the BCD coding, we have to take all of numbers as a digit. Let's see that. For example, we have 185. If you want to convert binary, you just divide the two, right? It's the binary, so the decimal to binary conversion. But if you want to write is as a BCD coding, you have to take all of numbers individually. For example, 1. What is means 1? It means 0001, right? So write it. It means 0001. 8. What does it mean? It means in the binary 1000. 5. What is the 5 in the binary system? 0101. So you have the BCD. It's just like easy. So there is a rules about the BCD addition, but I don't prefer the using these rules. But if you prefer, you can use. There is the addition part, for example. 4 plus 8, it means 12, right? In the BCD part, if you convert 12, what will you do? You do what you do, take the 1, and it means 0001, and you take the 2, it means 0010. But there is a rule, you can add the numbers and you will use the 6. 6 is special. You always use the 6. Don't ask why, because I don't know either. There is kind of rule. But it works. If you add the two numbers and if you add the 6 the results, you get the BCD. But I don't prefer that. I prefer that one. I take all of numbers individually and I just write it. So there is also examples. And the other decimal codes, it is just the general information about the digital systems. We are using decimal digits and BCD. We don't use 24, 21. We don't use excess 3. This is the old one. And if you have any interest in, you can research. You don't responsible from that one in this lesson. It is just the general information. So the gray code, what does it mean? It is important because, as I said, if we get a chance to write hardware coding in the FPGA, we will design the logic circuits and we will use state machines. Also, we will see in the next weeks. The binary gray coding is important. It is also using in the state machine, but you don't know the state machines yet. So I will just say the basic rules about the gray code. So If you want to count numbers, what will you say? You say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? But in the gray code, 0 is the 0, 0, 0, and only you can change one bit. All of steps. You continue the steps, but you only have to change one bit. So, for example, 0, 0, 0, it means 0. 0, 0, 1, it means once. 0, 0, 1, 1, it means 2. So, what is the 2 in binary system? It actually is 0, 0, 1, 0, right? So, if you want to write 2, you have to change 2 bits. The right one and this one. You have to change this one 0 to 1. You have to change this one 1 to 0 to get 2. But in gray code, for the only change one bit, they make this truth table. You can memorize it, but if you do a lot of exercise, you will see them. Okay, Mohammed, please keep it quick. So, I think you can talk now, but I cannot hear you. So, as I said, in the gray code, you only change one bit. It seems not ineffective now, but you will see that it is very effective just changing one bit and do the process. It is important, but you will see it in the laboratory, not in this course. So, there is a ASCII code, American Standard Code for Information Interchange. This is also the general information if we use the FPGA, and if we go to the laboratory, you will also see the ASCII code, but now it's just a general information. You can memorize them, you can research them. I don't know about the laboratory. I think the department will announce about it. Okay, there is also ASCII character codes. Okay, let's pass this one and go to the binary codes. I will upload the other presentation. It takes a few minutes. Okay. I think you can see the presentation. Okay, let's see something about binary coding. We have the binary numbers for the process, right? It means a signals, the binary signals we have to process or transfer or calculation. So, there is some rules about the binary system transformation. If you want to send data, you always use the binary system, like the TVs, like the computers. But there is some protocols, rules. The basic one, we will say that. For example, the DEDEX errors in data communication and processing and 8 bits is something added to ASCII character to indicate its parity. What does it mean, the parity? So, a parity bit is an extra bit included with a message to make the total numbers of first either even or odd. So, what does it mean? Let's see. We want to transfer data, right? And the receiver don't know the data. They have to get data correctly. But something happens in while the transfer. It can be missing bit, it can be change bit. That means error. All of bits can change or can erase, can clear. That means error. For that we use parity bits. When the receiver get data, first thing it do to check the parity one. So it knows before the gets data, it has the parity or not. But is there any parity bits? As I said, the receiver knows that. It checks the parity bit firstly. Parity bit means, for example, this one is parity. You can see the point, right? This one means parity. If the parity bits is one, it means the number of one is even. We will see the example. I think something happened in the presentation. Just 1 minute. Sorry, it was interrupted again. Okay, let's see the parity bits. If the parity bits is one, let's see that one. The code word has even parity if the numbers of first in the code words is even. We calculate the ones. For example, this one. How many one? This binary system have 1, 2. It's even, right? So parity bit must be 0 or 1. It is your decided. Let's see that. It's the first. It's mean even, and is the 0. It means odd. Okay. It's your decided. You can decide the, that if I say 1, it means there is a number of 1 is even. You can say all of them. So the other one, how many 1 it has? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? It's even also. And you can use the 1 for the parity. The other one, we have 1, 2, 3, 1. It means the odd, and you can use the 0. So there is a 3-1 in here, and you can also use the 0. So parity bits means if there any error or any corruption, is there any mistake bits, you can see that. But you don't know which one is correct, which one is error. So if you have a parity errors, you can do two things. You can erase all of the data until the parity bits, or you can ask the resource to resend it again. You said sent the signal and said, please resend, send again the data. There is a mistake. You can do it with parity. So There was also redundancy. It's not important also. So, a binary cell is a device that processes two stable states and is capable of storing one of the two states. What is the register? A binary, you know the binary. It can be one or zero. But what about register? Register is a group of binary cells. A register with n cells can store any discrete quantity of information that contains n bits. So, if you have 10 cells in your register data, you have 2 power of 10 possible states. Register is important when we start to create logic circuits. You will use always registers. You will put the binary cells together and get the registers, and you will use them. As I say, binary cell has two stable states, store one bit of information. It can be zero or one, right? There is also two state. Example, flip-flops. Flip-flops is the most important one. There is a ferrite course capacitor, but flip-flops, in this course, flip-flops is the most important one. We will see that. Register is a group binary cells. There's an example, for example, X in 86 CPU earning. It's a register. Register transfer, a transfer of the information stored in one register to another. One of the major operator in digital system. Okay, let's see the example. Digital computer example. This is kind of confusing for you, maybe, but it is just basic rules. We will see the other rules, and it will be make sense for you. Don't worry. A digital computer exam, for example, there is a memory, you know, as you know, and memory, we do memory with registers. Always, we use the registers for the make the memory. Control units, data pads, you will see them. What is the data pad? It means how many bits you use, how many bits you want to transfer. 8 bits, 16, it's your choice. Control units and input-output parts. And it is also your choice, synchronous or asynchronous. So there's another example. There's a keyboard example. You have keyboards. In the keyboards, all of character has 8 cells. And can you see my voice? Can you hear me? I think you have to refresh. Okay, let's see the keyboards example again. There's the control parts. You will see the control lectures, don't worry. And 8 cells. All of the characters from the keyboard is the 8 cells. And you have the processor. What you want is you do in there. And memory units. So, there is another example. There is also input-output. There is also memory units. As you can see, all of them is register. The one register, the others. So let's pass that again. So, binary logic. Can you read the slides? It is a little bit small, I think, but I cannot make it bigger. Maybe this one. So, it is better, I think. Okay. Definition of binary logic. Binary logic consists of binary variables of and set of logical operations. The variables are designed by letters of the alphabet such as A, B, C. We use A, B, C in hexadecimal, right? Not the binary systems. With each variable have two and only two distinct possible values, 1 and 0. Three basic logical operators. We will see the operations the next slide. Just read them. AND operator, it means AND gate, actually. We will see that. This operation is represented by a dot or by the absence of the operation. If you use dot or if you use absence, it means AND. And you read it like that. X and Y equal Z. The logical operation AND is interpreted mean that Z equal 1 if only X 1 and Y 1. We will see that. That is the rules of the AND gate. Don't worry, we will see that. Or we will represent it or by plus. If you use plus, it means X or Y equals Z. And not, there is a three basic logical operation, AND, OR, NOT. This operation is represented by a prime. For example, X dash, it means NOT X, equals zero. You can also say X one complement. You can also say that X one complement Z. It is the same. So, let's take a look through the table, but we will say the next presentation AND or NOT gate. There's a truth table of them. We will see that. This is kind of important. You can keep your mind. It can be helped to keep your mind. AND gate is just like a serial switch. OR gates. It's like a parallel switch. If you take off one of these switch, the light is open, right? But for the AND gate, you have to close both of them. Both switch have to be closed. It maybe help you memorize it. And there is a logic gates means in the circuits, in the logical circuits. Actually, we use always 5 volts. Not always, but often we use the 5 volts, but sometimes we use the 3 volts. It means logic 1. And this part means logic 0. This means it's closed. This means it's open. This kind of fuzzy logic, maybe you will see in the third years in your university. But right now, it means nothing, undefined. So there is also logic gates. We will see them. Don't worry. Okay, let's do the another. I am uploading another presentation. It will be take few minutes. We will see all of gates in the algebra. Now we will learn about the algebra and we will see all of gates in here. Yes, it's not hard. It's so easy. Trust me. It's also fun. Yes, I will upload all of slides in the system. No, you can see the new presentation, right? It is uploading. Is there any connection lost? Please don't leave the lessons. If lessons finish, I will save you. Maybe I have some connection errors and I will disconnect. Please don't leave the lesson until I say. Okay. Boolean algebra. It is the important one for the logic circuits. We will see in there basic operation. Basic operation means and, or, and, not. Boolean expression and truth table. Basic theorems. Commutative, associative, distributive law, simplification theorem, multiplying out and factoring, and De Morgan's law. Okay, what is algebra? I think you didn't hear about it. Maybe some of you hear it already. Boolean algebra. What is algebra? Mathematical system consists of set of elements, set of operators, axioms and postulates. All of mathematical system has all of this. Why is important? Defines rules of calculation. And we will see some examples. And you will need paper and pencil in that part. I hope you keep them. And operator with two inputs are called binary. It is not the binary we know. It is just the binary. It means two inputs. For example, when it is a one input are called unary. Don't mix them. Also, we will use the binary numbers in there, but for the general information, the binary in here, it means just two inputs. Okay. The father of Boolean algebra, an algebra developed in the 19th century by George Boole. He is an English mathematician. He has well studied the theory. This branch of mathematics called Boolean algebra is a discrete algebra in which the variable can have one of two values. Either it's like the binary system, it can only have zero or one. Associated with the algebra is a number of the theorems which allow the manipulation and simplification of the Boolean equation. George Boolean, as I said, is developed it the 19th century, but it is pick up with the idea is eventually the one bright student, Claude Shannon. So when he was living, nobody said thanks to him, and he didn't have any rewards. The people didn't know what actually he found. The people didn't recognize what actually the George Boole is found come with. So, and surprisingly, given his standing in the academic community, Boole's idea was either criticized or completely ignored by majority of the peers. All of them ignored it. They said, we have decimal systems, we don't need the binary system. But in the 1960, the Claude Shannon is run with this brilliant idea. So, let's see the objective about this Boolean algebra. Topics introduced in this chapter: understand the basic operation and law of Boolean algebra. We will see that. Relate these operation and laws and or not gates and switches also. Prove these laws using the truth table. We will prove all of them. We will prove all of the laws. Manipulation of the algebraic expression using multiplying out, factoring, simplifying, finding the component of the expression. So, basic mathematics for logic design, it means Boolean algebra. So, Boolean algebra means basic mathematics for the logic design. So, we only use 1 or 0 switching algebra. Boolean variables can be x, y, z, whatever you want. You can use all of alphabets. So that is why Alcold is binary, not like binary we saw, not just one or zero. You can use x, y, z, a, b, c, whatever alphabet you want. So just see the gates. Start with not. It means invert. So it means also one complement, we can say. So inverter. Not zero means one, and not one means zero. It is the very easy, very simple. So we use that simple to represent it. It's triangular and there is kind of circle. It means not gate. This is the not gate. So AND gate. AND gate has a truth table. What did we say about the that? We said it's AND, represented AND, right? It means 0 and 0 equal 0. 0 and 1 equal 0. Only equal 1 is 0 and 0. It's kind of, we saw that, it's kind of serial switch. All of switch have to close for the light. So this is its symbols. It is AND gate symbols. You have to know that. So there is OR gates. There is also truth table about OR gates. And we use the plus for represent OR, right? Zero OR, zero means zero. The other ones is one. It is kind of the parallel switch. One of them is just closed is enough. Not need the both of them close. And there's a switch represented. And but we know that AND gate is like two serial switch. OR gate is like two parallel switch. So let's see this operation. Let's see this example. It means A, not B, this one. A and not B, this one. You can see the point, right? A and not B. Or C, this is the results. Can you write the, create the circuits for this one, A and C or D and complement and OR B and E. Can you try to create this? I will take you maybe 3 minutes for that. I hope you keep pencil and paper. Just do this exercise. If anybody's finished, just say done. This is the basic operators. You will only use AND or NOT. Okay. Good. There is Hamza, there is Amen. Hamza, Ansaf, and Amen, Olmaz. You should do the create the circuits from this expression. There is a circuits of logic gates. There is this example, but I want you to do this expression to using gates. By using gates, it must be equal with that expression. But you will only use the gates. So good. I'm just taking a photo, it's easier. Okay. Okay, let's see that. Let's see the other slides. Who did right? Who is correct? There is a C and D. It means or. And A, C and D, or and A. And complement, the inverter one, or B and E, the results. Okay, good. Everybody connect. So, there is a logic evaluation. For example, you can give the numbers A, B, C is equal 1, D and E equal 0. You can change them. And you get the answer. So let's see the rules. Let's see first. Let's see the truth table. Truth table provides basic methods of the describing a Boolean function. We use the truth tables always. It contains a row for every combination of the variables and prescribes the value of the function. It means 0 or 1. And all of these combinations is present the 0 or 1. So let's see that. Let's see the example. We have two input, right? A and B. When we see the circuits, we have only two inputs. So how many variables we need? How many row we need? It's 2^2, right? It means four row we need to write. It's one of them is 0, 0, the other 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. And we done all of combination. So there is a wire. Connection wire, not A, right? There's a connection. It's not an input, but it's a connection wire. We must use it. So there's the results. A, not A, or B. So we can get not A from the A parts. We have A parts, right? 0, 0, 1, 1. This one, the A parts. And we can flip them. Just flip it and invert. Just invert it and get 1, 1, 0, 0. And B or A. Or means the parallel switch. So if 0, 0, it means 0. The others is 1. It's just like the parallel switch. Truth table is specifies the values of the Boolean expression for every possible combination of the values in the expression. We have four combination, right? Possible combination. Because we have two inputs, 2^2 is mean 4. Okay, proof using truth table. So we have this expression. A and not B or C. It says equal A or C and not B or C. Is it true or wrong? We need a truth table for this. So, we have three inputs, right, in this expression, A, B, C. We have three inputs. So, how many row we need? It's 2 power of 3. It means 8. We need 8 row. So, it started with 0, 0, 0 and it finished with 1, 1, 1. It is all of combination for the inputs. So, we need not B, it is the wire. Can you imagine the circuits? This expression, there is a not B, there is a and not B, and there is a this part results. This part is A and not B or C. This part is only this. The other part is A or C, not B or C, and the results. Results is A, the end of each other. So, how many rows we need is, we said is 8, and we write all of combination. We found not B for using B, right? It's just inverted. We can write A and not B. A is this 0 0 0 1 1 1, and not B is this. We can and them and write the results. So 0 and 1 means 0. 0 and 1 means 0. Only one is like a serial switch. Both of them must be one. Like this. Like this. So we have A and not B, and we have C also. We can OR them. So we get the results. A and not B or C. We got the results. We can do all of them like this. We have A and C, just OR them. 0 or 0 means 0. 0, 1 means 1, like a parallel switch. Also, we have not B in here and we have C. We can OR them. So we can add these results. So compare this one and compare from this one and this one. Compare those. They are equal, right? So it means this expression is true. We just proved them. We just proved it. So I think you have to refresh, but it's let's write that. So let's see the basic theorems. There is a theorems. X or 0 means X, right? 0 is just ineffective elements in OR operation. Let's see the OR gates truth table. This is OR gates truth table. If one of them is 0, we look the other one. 0 is ineffective elements for the OR operation. 1 is ineffective elements for the AND operation. If one of them is 1, the results equals the others. So, effective elements is 1 in the OR operation. If we use 1, results must be always 1, just like the parallel switch. If one of the switch is closed, it means shortcut and light is off. But in the serial switch, if any of them is open, that means it's close to light. The zero is effective for the AND operation. So, idempotent law, as you see, it's very simple. X AND X equal X. You can prove all of them it yourself. And if you got not and not again, the second not is the equal X. It's the power of 2, maybe power. And X or X not equal 1, because one of them must be 1, right? If X equals 0, it means this one is 1. If it is X 1 is equals 1. So this operator is equals 1. This operator is equals 0. You can prove them yourself. It is easy. So there is an example. A and not B or D, parenthesis, E and 1 is 1. And you can use this complement. You can this one and this one, it equals 0. Because there is a 1. There is a 1, and this element, this expression is ineffective for our operation. It's meaningless what it takes. It can be 0 or it can be 1. It's not important. The results is the same 1. In that, there is one expression and there is not. So it means 0. One of them has to be 0. So in the AND element, effective 0 is effective and equals is the 0. The result is the 0. So there is a switch circuits, we say again. There is another laws. We can commutative the numbers. So what does it mean? It means X and Y, if X and Y equals Y and X, so this is the same for the OR operation. Let's see another associative laws. It means you can took the parentheses wherever you want. It is like a decimal number, right? It is same for the decimal numbers. You can use the parentheses wherever you want. So it is the AND operation and OR operation. It is the same. You can use them. And proof of this, there's a truth table. You can study with this details. So there is a Boolean theorems. There is a table in here. You know that these rules, right? And Huntington postulates. Postulates means kind of law, kind of theorems. But we use this phrase for the Boolean theorems. Okay, let's see that. This is a basic theorems of the Boolean algebra. You know this one, and also you know this one. Okay. Let's see this. Also, there is a proof about that. All of them equals X. It's not important. It is just the basic rules of AND OR gates. This is proof of X or X equals X. You know that already. And there's a proof about X and X equals X. You know that either already. And this one, One is the effective for the OR operation. Okay, there is a truth table about the these laws. Let's see De Morgan's theorem. It is important one. De Morgan's theorem said that if we get x or y and take it the NOT gate, so it's equal NOT x and NOT y. We separate, we change the operation OR to AND, and we took all of the inputs NOT as a NOT, NOT x and NOT y. It is the same for reverse. If we have x and y, not x and y, it equals not x or not y. You have to memorize it. In my advice, memorize this theorem. It is easy, but you have to keep it in your mind because you will use that in calculation, also in circuits. So there's a truth table about that. You can see the truth table. I think can you hear me? Okay, can you hear me now? Sorry for this connection. Okay, we are saying De Morgan's theorem. And there is a proof table table about De Morgan's theorem. We saw the theorems, it's AND and represents the OR. We just changed the NOT here. And let's see the truth table. We have two inputs, x and y, right? And we have four possible combination. It's 2^2, and we have four possible combination. X and y is our inputs, and we can get not x and not y. Also, we can get x or y, and x or y not. Not x or y. Also, we can get not x and not y. So let's see this table. The theorems say that x and y complement means it's equal not x and not y. Let's see not x and not y. It's 1, 0, 0, 0. And see that one is also 1, 0, 0. It's the equal. It's the proof of De Morgan's theorem. Also the other parts, this one, it's equal 1, 1, 1, 0. And each expression equal each other. So let's see another theorem is consensus theorem. It says x and y or x and z or y and z equals that expression. You have to